Center for Cellular and Molecular Platforms, also known as CCAMP, is set to see more of its startups it has incubated receive global funding. There's also room for support from the Indian corporate sector, on especially for research on fighting superbugs. That's the word coming in from the director at the Innovation Hub. We check into the CCAMP campus in Bangalore. Give us a lowdown of, you know, what has come from CCAMP in terms of innovation, patents, commercial products. Just give us an idea of what's really come out of CCAMP so far.
While we have touched around 1,000 startups or more, in our portfolio, the ones that we have funded with the support of BIRAC, NITI Aayog, AIM, and other support from Government of Karnataka, we are 150 startups of our own in a portfolio.
Across the country?
Across the country. Okay. So footprint is across. So we are headquartered here, but our footprint through our innovations is across the country.
Right.
And what they are working on is a completely cutting-edge science going forward, like the only startup in 2019 in world's game-changing innovations from India across all sectors is from us, that is Bugworks.
Of course.
Right? So it is phenomenal.
The global rock star.
Absolutely.
One of the global rock stars.
One of the global rock stars and the only Indian startup to be named in top 30 or 35 of the world.
Right.
We have another startup which is working for environment, you know, converting biomass, that is like methane, using microbial technology or synthetic biology, as you would call it, to something from methane gas, which is which causes global warming, to what you would rather call it as you know, non-human food. So waste to wealth in a best case scenario.
Interesting.
But all of that has a common theme, and I have several more examples, but I will not take up much time. But a common theme that runs there is a phenomenal deep science.
Absolutely.
And this scientific temperament that we are building at CCAMP allows us to pick those ideas.
Absolutely.
Take the risk of validating it to the next level with the entrepreneur and enabling it by, you know, connecting with the regulators, funders, government, and so on.
Right. And that is one point I want to come to, the validation.
Correct. Absolutely.
How many patents have come out? And I understand there are so many products that are in the market that have come out from
Correct.
Here.
Correct.
Just give us an idea of that.
So, see, I think, first of all, we are in a deep science field where the technology takes longer time to come in,
right?
But regardless, we already have 14 odd products which are in the market.
Okay.
Right? And that's a very good thing because we are in the business of entrepreneurship for the last 7 years.
Right.
While CCAMP started 2009-10, the entrepreneurship vertical started it around 2013-14.
Right.
And within that, we have 14 products in the market. We have more than 60 to 70 patents which are, you know, across the globe have been protected. And what we are looking at is around those innovations are now being funded heavily by VCs across the globe.
Yeah.
So there are VCs who are funding from India, France, US, Japan, China, and so on. And that clearly indicates that the science that we are building on towards innovation
has a commercial value.
Absolutely,
as well.
Absolutely.
And I think more than 40 startups that incubated here have now gone on to raise future rounds of funding.
Indeed, indeed, absolutely.
Recently, the government has, you know, come out saying that a little portion of the CSR that companies have should go towards incubators and accelerators that are, you know, supported by the government.
Correct.
How will that really help? Will you see an ecosystem kind of support because of this?
Or no, absolutely. It's a welcome note. It's a welcome note that they have expanded the possibility of CSR fund. If I'm not wrong, it has been around for 3-4 years for DST and BIRAC funded incubators.
Okay.
It has been that the CSR fund could be given. Unfortunately for us, we haven't seen much coming our way.
Okay.
What we realize is that possibly a lot of CSR funds go to other initiatives which are possibly on Swachh India and all that.
The big campaigns,
which are important, but somehow the incubators, the importance to incubators, support to incubators has been missed out, or possibly the ones which are doing good stuff but do not have the 30, 40 years of brand with them. And I think there should be, because these are the support system, the most important ecosystem support system, which will actually take your new economic drivers of India next level.
Right.
I think there is a need to support them, not to create them, but take it them to the highest
level. Of course. So
that
that's
center
the
of excellences have to be created and supported in multiple ways. One, I would say, I would argue that creating those is a good idea. I would say pick a few of them and make them world class.
Shaul, Bugworks is a big success story out of CCAMP. Tell us how your work here has helped you go global. I understand you're doing trials, clinic trials outside as well. Tell us a little bit about that and your new funding from CARBEX and where that is being, you know, utilized.
Yeah, Bugworks is a startup biopharmaceutical company. It's incubated at CCAMP. And we got initial fund from Virac, thanks to CCAMP, because we are incubated here. So that helped us to initially grow up our concept and establish the concept. So that we have taken into a global funding agency, which is called CARBEX.
Yeah.
So the current project, what we are working on, finding a novel antibiotic to address the emerging threat of AMR, antimicrobial resistance, especially in the hospital setup and post-operative surgery and people who are undergoing cancer chemotherapy.
Right.
So this antibiotic will be of useful, very useful.
Okay.
So that we got a funding from CARBEX.
On that note, it is time.